And now, your NBC 26 Storm Shield forecast with meteorologist Gino Recchia.
All right. Well, not too bad, Abby. What do you think about the forecast that we saw today?
It looks really good. I mean, it's just like that nice air that you can get out there, go for a walk.
You almost forgot you're looking through the papers to figure out.
I did. I'm like,
what was the weather today?
It was wonderful. I was looking forward to those 80s and 90s next week.
It's going to get warm out there.
Did you have any plants that you had to bring in? Because I know we were talking about that frost advisory last night.
So most areas up towards the north did see some frost, like Land O'Lakes by the UP into parts of northwest Wisconsin. But for us, most here, not really did see much with temperatures in the upper 30s and lower 40s. So that's good news. And, you know, might as well be safe if you brought the plants in. Then sorry, some low-lying areas did see some pretty chilly weather. Matter of fact, up in Washington Island, they got down to 32 degrees overnight. As for highs today, we got upper 60s and lower 70s. A few high-level clouds were coming through, but overall a very nice day. How about the time lapse as we take a full screen on that? We've had lots of quiet conditions across our area. And as we get into the forecast over the next couple of days, it's going to start to change. One, it's going to get a little more humid, and also it's going to get a lot warmer outside. It is currently sitting at 68 in Green Bay. We've got 73 in Wapaka, 71 in Shawano, 70 in Clintonville, and lower 60s and upper 50s right now along the shoreline. The winds are starting to change out of the west and southwest on the backside of the high pressure that brought in the pretty chilly air for yesterday, but it is drier as well with this Canadian high pressure. So I've been having my windows open, getting that fresh air, because these dew points that are nice, cool, crisp, they're going to get a lot more humid over the coming days, just the next 48 hours. Warm front lifts northward. Looks like the most humid day over the next 7 days will be as we get into Tuesday, with high temperatures climbing up into the upper 80s and lower 90s. I'll show a map about that coming shortly. But here's a thin band of some high-level clouds moving northward. As for the rest of us, we're seeing plentiful sunshine out there. And take just look off towards the west. Nothing's going on here. We've got a high pressure right now in control, but this high is scooting off to the east. We've got a strong area of low pressure right now over the Rockies and this warm front that's extending southward. This warm front, the whole storm system itself, is going to be moving eastward, and that's going to be sparking off a few showers and thunderstorms. There is a slight risk of severe weather as we get into tomorrow, and then a slight and a marginal risk of severe weather as we get into Tuesday, so something certainly to monitor. As for the next 24 to 48 hours, we will be seeing clouds increasing and a few showers and thunderstorms will be developing initially out of the north, and then they'll start to move down to the south as we get into the afternoon. Some of these storms could have the potential for some hail and gusty winds. But then as we get into Tuesday, how about these temperatures? The warmest highs of the season are coming to northeast Wisconsin. So for tonight, we'll drop down to 50 degrees, southwest winds at 5 miles per hour. Tomorrow, we'll climb up to a high of 71, south winds at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Over the coming days, Tuesday will be the warmest, 88, and then we do start to cool off a little bit as we get into the end of the work week and into the weekend. High temperatures will be dropping down into the lower 70s, I should say, by the weekend, with a few chance of on and off showers and thunderstorms, Abby.
I was going to say, did we mention that? Did you have any plants that you had to bring inside?
No, I decided to just leave them out. Some of the plants that I have are kind of hardy, so like a light frost ain't going to damage them.
I was going to say, I left mine out last night, but I also live in the Green Bay area, so it wasn't too bad. And she's still living this morning, so I think
Wow, look at that. You're doing a good job.
Thanks. Well, we'll be right back.